Welcome to Bristol for the run of the Food Safe 500. On the pole for today's race is Grace Ace Vito, and to the outside is Reese Dooley. In third is Jim Gambit, fourth is Hank Caldwell, and fifth is Tony Green. So the half mile concrete oval in Bristol, Tennessee. Race 5, pace car in 75 laps. Green flag is out, we're racing. They come off of two. Dooley got the walls around! With the 34, everyone gets through. The caution will come out. Grace Acevedo gets them back. It looks like they're gonna keep it clean coming back. As long as they don't wreck right here, they're three wide. All right, so it looks like Reese Dooley and the 34 Tony Green, the only ones involved. Let's see what happens. Here's what happened, you see. Here on lap one, the 40 of Reese Dooley up high is going to smack the wall and come down into the 34 of Tony Green. Has nowhere to go. Reese Dooley gets the most damage from that backside in the outside wall. Everyone else able to just drive through it. Drive around it. Oh, and the 52 Jake Moss went down pit road. So Grace Acevedo led them back. They're going to stay out. Actually, no, they're coming into pit road. That is an interesting decision. Some cars do not pit. Looks like the 2 and the 10 will stay out. Larry Bouchard Jr. and Nathan Hood will lead us back to the green flag. Gracie Acevedo, first off pit road, Hank Caldwell second. They just took fuel only, but actually it's Larry Bouchard Sr. as Larry Bouchard Jr. will be out until Talladega. So the 2 car leads back to the green flag. Going back around lap 7, and Jake Moss is 2 laps down. Gary May is lap down. Problems for that 88 car. So your race leader will be the 2 of Larry Bouchard Sr. Second is Nathan Hood. Third is the 7 of Grace Acevedo. First off pit road, they took fuel only. Fourth is Hank Caldwell, and fifth is Jordan Cross. And sixth is Aiden Shepard. Seventh is Jim Gambit. Eighth is Jonathan Buford. Ninth is John West. And tenth is Braylon Beasley. See Gary May lining up to the inside as the pace car coming in. Yeah, 88 to lap down on the inside could hurt the 2 car here. Green flag. And yeah, look at that. Gary May stayed with Larry Bouchard Sr. And that's going to cost him right here. So he's going to come off the corner, hit the wall. Down to Nathan Hood. Grace Acevedo's all over the place. Nathan Hood's away with the lead. Now Larry Bouchard Sr.'s in the wall again. Still riding it. Jordan Cross around on the front stretch. Jonathan Buford got some damage. Oh, Morgan Willis flipped him. And the 23 is involved. Jay Jefferson is in it. You saw AJ Green and the 23 hit him. Jordan Cross comes to rest upside down. Nathan Hood leads them back. Ooh, my God. Looks like Gary May actually fell behind those two. I'm going to see what happened here. Oh, looks like went really wide through 1 and 2. He's going to hit the wall right here. Oh, my goodness. And Gary May was going to get back on the lead lap, but now can't. He's just going to slam the wall through the corner. So let's see what happened. This wreck resulted in Jordan Cross going upside down. What just happened here was Larry Bouchard Sr. up on the high side. Gonna hit the wall. Still in the wall. And then Hayden Caldwell goes high. Aiden Shepard looks to make it 3 wide. Caldwell got the wall and Jordan Cross didn't give him any room. Cross spun it. And right there, Jonathan Buford got some damage but kept it going. Braylon Beasley somehow avoided. And right there, Morgan Willis will flip the 3 of Jordan Cross, and nowhere to go for AJ Green, the 23. J. Jefferson, the 14, and that Mobile 1 Chevy got some damage on that car. But that 3 car stayed upside down. The caution came out. Nathan Hood led them back. As you see, Grace Acevedo, they're getting into the 10 a little bit. They're going to let these guys go. They're going to stay out. And the 10 car, Nathan Hood, is back to the green flag. Going back around lap 14, and because of this wreck, the 23 is out of the race. AJ Green, that's the only one. So the 3 cars still in it. And look, all the guys lap down because of this. We only have 26 cars on the lead lap. Because those guys slowed up, Nathan Hood able to put them a lap down. Hood's your race leader. Second is Aiden Shepard. Third is Ken Bell. Fourth is Chris Dodd. And fifth is Adam Mihal. So we've got some cars lap down. This could be interesting for Nathan Hood on the outside. The pace car is in. We're going back green right here. Green flag is back out. Let's see if we can make it cleanly a lap. Or two. Try and get the green flag pit stops, maybe. They come down the back stretch into the inside, Zane Shepherd. And we'll take the lead from Nathan Hood, who hits the outside wall. Aiden Shepherd is now leading the field. At Bristol's, Jake Moss gets the wall in front. It is now blowing up. He hit the wall so hard. Tough break for the 52. Now Aiden Shepherd gets the outside wall. And it's coming down pit road. That's because he did not pit. Or did... Looks like everyone, a lot of people are coming down pit road. So Ken Bell stays out. I think this could play into the hands of people who stayed out here. Because when a caution comes out, it probably will soon. Because Ken Bell's up in that wall hard with Nathan Hood. Look at all the Kais on pit road. And the caution is out. There it is. We said something like that was going to happen, and it did. And that's just going to put this down to about 20 people who now can win this race, as there are so many guys going to be a lap down. Let's see what happened to bring out the caution. Looks like, who's the race leader? Ken Bell is the race leader. Let's see what happened. Three wide doesn't work here at Bristol. Larry Burchard Sr. makes it three wide. Jeff Bright's in the middle, bouncing off Braylon Beasley and Larry. Larry pushes Jeff up into Braylon. They're going to make it. Then they couldn't right there. Jeff spins in front of the field and actually saves it. Keeps it going, but the yellow comes out. Ken Bell is your race leader, and that traps many people laps down. And they're going to stay out even more. So, or no, they're coming into pit road right here. And because of this, there are only 20 cars on the lead lap. Many are one down, but a lot are two down. The 52 is out Jake Moss because of a fuel pump. The 3 has actually retired from the race. Jordan Cross, they could not get that car fixed. They were trying to and just could not do it. So we're going to see who comes first off pit road. The guys that are laps down, pit under green, they would be smart to stay out here, get their laps back. Looks like at least two tires going to be going on for these guys. Looks like it's going to be four tires. Let's see who gets out of the way in first. It's going to be the two car, or the I don't know who's lap down and who's not here. I don't know if the 22 is on the lead lap. He is not, I believe. The two cars on the lead lap and gets out in first, so Larry Bouchard Sr. should lead us back to the green flag. Going green lap 23, and from that wreck, no cars are out. You see the lap cars lining up to the inside. Your race leader is Gracie Sevito, surprisingly. Second will be Derek Bouchard. Third will be Larry Bouchard Sr. Fourth is Ken Bell, and fifth is the 4 of Eli Bright. They come into the restart zone. Gracie Sevito, your race leader. Look, all cars on the inside lap down. Green flag is back in the air. What the 38th Griffin Lynn wants to do is stay to the inside to get a lap back, and look at that. Stays down there. Grayson's in the wall, clips TJ. TJ's around with Grayson, who hits. Larry Bouchard Sr. does. Oh, and Reese Dooley. They are wrecking everywhere. Oof. Who leads them back? These guys get their lap back, and Derek Bouchard will lead them back. Let's see what happened. Another wreck on another restart here at Bristol. Gracie Sevito up high. Hits the wall. Clips TJ Hanley after coming off the wall. TJ spins it. Grayson spins it. You see those guys down there getting through. And right there, Larry Bouchard Sr. is going to get clipped. Looks like Jose Fernandez might be able to make it through. Here comes the 48 and the 1. There's Reese Dooley. Looks like the 1 of Tommy Turbo got damaged. Paul Minnick got damaged. Braylon Beasley hit the 1, it looked like. Oh my goodness, what in the world? And then even bigger wreck on the off of the corner. You see people trying to avoid. They're trying to come back up. And it looks like right there, Peyton Beasley comes up. And Beno Lothair Irvine up in the air. Gary May saw that. Jim Gamba able to get through. Jonathan Buford. There's Colin McGovern. Braylon Beasley. Look at all these guys just piling in here. Jeff Bright. Unbelievable. what happened. Let's go on board with Gary May. Daytona 500 winner has an on board. That's going to be insane. That's going to take a lot of people out of this race. Let's also go on board with last season's champion, Jeff Bright, in the 5 car. Looks like he was a part of this wreck. Alright, so leading them back to the caution was the 20 of Derek Bouchard, and he's on pit road. We'll have to see where everyone is. Looks like the 9 of Justin Heath has cycled around to the lead, don't know how that happened. And there are even less cars on the lead lap now. Only 13 on the lead lap as of now. Justin Heath is your race leader. And we'll go back green this time on lap 29. Heath is the race leader. And from that accident, the 88 of Gary May, the 66 of Benoit Lothair Irvine, the 26 of Peyton Beasley, the 40 of Reese Dooley, the 7 of Gracie Sabido, the 4 of Eli Bright, 99 of John West, and the 32 of Adam Michal are all out of this race. Now there are only 13 cars on the lead lap, with Justin Heath leading, Ken Bell in second, Nathan Hood third, Dan Bandon fourth, and Michael Gregory fifth. Then sixth is Levi Schoen, seventh is Tony Green, and eighth is Derek Bouchard, ninth is Luke Rainey, and tenth is Jim Gamba as they come off of 4. Green flag is back out. Heath steps on the gas, gets away from the field. And Heath is gone. Heath won earlier this year at Auto Club, I think it was. Oh, look at that! Ken Bell spun, hit Dan Bandon. Levi Schoen's got some damage. And that was a freak accident. Justin Heath will come around and lead them back. What happened there? Let's see what happened. It looked like Ken Bell's car just snapped around on him or something like that. Look at this going down the corner. Ken Bell's second place. Car gets away from him. He slides up the track and hits the wall. And this ruined Dan Bandon's day as Dan Bandon comes along, nails him, hits Griffin Lynn. Levi Schoen's got some damage there from him, Dan Bandon. Eric Heiden got damage. But I think the biggest loser here is Dan Bandon. Look at, he's going to be out of this race because of that. Unbelievable has been happening. Justin Heath led them back. He was all by himself, and now he's on pit road again. Just so many pit stops, so many wrecks. Short track racing at its finest. And something a lot of the drivers do not like about short track racing is this right here. Just so many wrecks. All the... Just... Oh, no. So much confusion. Justin Heath out on pit road first, but now we're going to have to see who stays out is the question. Because look at all these lap down cars pitting. Right now, Justin Heath should be scored as the race leader first off pit road. I think that's how it's going to happen. We'll see if Justin Heath leads us back to the green flag, but someone will lead us back to the green flag. Going back green with 40 laps to go. And from that accident, there are more cars that have retired from the race. Eric Heiden, Griffin Lynn, the 36 of Ken Bell, and the 41 of Levi Schoen's are out, along with the 98 of Ian Shepard and the 51 of Dan Bandon. So 10 cars are now on the lead lap, only 10 people. Justin Heath, Luke Rainey, the 13 of Braylon Beasley, the 10 of Nathan Hood, the 47 of Hayden Caldwell, Michael Gregory, and on. So the pace car's in, here we go. Green flag is back out. And Heath gets away again. Oh! Luke Rainey around! Oh! Someone just went in there hard and nailed the 70 of Colin McGovern. Derek Bouchard is in it. And the race back, of course, it's going to be Justin Heath as he was all by himself out of the head. As this race is unbelievable. Just a wreck fest of cars, sheet metal getting torn up. Let's see what happened. Here's what happened. Just people overdriving the corner, overdriving their cars, going over their head. Luke Rainey hits the wall and just spins in from the field. And then back there, the 16 drives in there. Eric Wills nails Colin McGovern. That was some Arca breaks right there. And Justin Heath will get out. And look at this. He's back on pit road. So I don't know what's happening here with these pit strategies, but not really making sense to us up here. But apparently the crew chiefs think this is what should be done. And if I were a lap car, I'd be staying out right here and getting laps back. As a 13 now out Piston, that's Braylon Beasley. So just so many cars going laps down. And cars out, we're not going to have any cars left in this race. Justin Heath first off pit road. I don't know if he's going to be... It looks like the 34 has stayed out. The 55 has stayed out will be a race leader, Michael Gregory. Going back green here on, I think, lap 40. Oh, probably 42. Yeah, going back in lap 42, and there are only, right now, 23 cars left in the race, and only 10 on the lead lap. Michael Gregory is your leader. 34 of Tony Green is second. Third is Jim Gambit. Fourth is Colin McGovern. Fifth is Derek Bouchard. Justin Heath, first off the row, is sixth. Seventh is Nathan Hood. Eighth is Hayden Caldwell. Ninth is Luke Rainey. And 10th is the 17, Morgan Willis. As the pace car is in, here we go. Green flag is back out. And Michael Gregory did not get going. Morgan Willis did not get going. That inside gets away just a little bit. So two cars get away from Michael Gregory, who is your race leader. Now in second is the 34 of Tony Green. Because it looks like the caution is already back out. Or no, I was just seeing things there. Michael Gregory is still your race leader. Tony Green trying to get past the lap cars. They're coming down pit road. The caution is out. That's a penalty if you go down pit road. The 16 looks like got spun around on the front stretch. The 11 will get a lap back. The 83 will get a lap back. Michael Gregory leads them back. Second was Jim Gambit. Let's see what happened. It looks like the 16 got spun around as Eric Willis. See right there, Morgan Willis hits the wall and is scraping it, can't get off it. Eric Willis goes low to avoid, but Morgan comes off the wall. Gonna have to right there. And there's just no room for four wide at a short track. And Eric Willis got spun by Jonathan Buford. And Michael Gregory led them back. He's on pit road. I doubt everyone's gonna be pitting again. So we'll see who leads us back to the green flag. Going green on lap 50. And as you can see from this, 23 cars are in the race, but only 10 on the lead lap. Jim Gambit is now your race leader. In second is Derek Bouchard. Third is Nathan Hood. Fourth is Justin Heath. And fifth is Luke Rainey. In sixth is Hayden Caldwell. Seventh is Tony Green. Eighth is Michael Gregory. Ninth is Colin McGovern. And tenth is Jeff Bright, who is on the tail of the lead lap. And there are two cars in between Jim Gambit and teammate Derek Bouchard, who are right now 1-2. As the pace car will go down pit road, and here we go, another restart. Can we keep it green this time is the question. Green flag! Jeff Bright gets away. Jim Gambit, though, coming up through the middle. Derek Bouchard's on the inside. He's gotten clear to the bottom. That's going to help him get past Jim Gambit, as Gambit had to slow up for the 5 car. Hitting the wall, but Bouchard got on the apron, and Jim Gambit's going to go right back around. And Sandroge is going to unlap himself right here. Sandroge unlaps himself. Jim Gambit is pitting. Jonathan Buford has got the wall. Derek Bouchard's now out front. We're keeping it green just a little bit here. Don't want to jinx anything, but right now keeping it clean. Tommy Turbo hits the wall in front of the leader, but keeps it going. Nathan Hood is up to second. And Nathan Hood is a long ways away from Derek Bouchard, who's right now way up here. As now, because of cars pitting, there are only 8 cars on the lead lap. Oh, and the 21 just popped the outside wall hard, as the 20 of Derek Bouchard didn't have problems. He hit the wall hard. Jacob West and Derek Bouchard just nailed the wall. Now the 31 of Jordan Bell's in the wall. Nathan Hood is trying to just get up there. Jeff Wright's now in the wall. Oh, and around he goes on the backstretch. Oh, gets nailed. The 55 of Michael Gregory got nailed by Jose Fernandez. Dodds get go low to avoid, as you see there. As here come cars racing around. Derek Bouchard leads us back, but Jeff Bright, last season's champion, around and causes a huge wreck. We saw Jeff Bright riding the wall right here. And it looks like Tony Green just didn't give him any room. And then right here, Colin McGovern came up in front of Michael Gregory. Gregory slid, but Jose Fernandez did not. Nailed into him. Justin Heath has damage. 15, Jonathan Buford got some damage. Cars fly by, but no one hits. And Derek Bouchard, your race leader, led them back. Looks like he's staying out. The 20 car is back to the green flag. Going back around lap 62, and more cars are now out of this race. The 83 Jose Fernandez and the 55 Michael Gregory. That leaves 21 cars left in the race and only 7 on the lead lap. Derek Bouchard is your race leader. Nathan Hood is second. Tony Green is third. Luke Rainey is fourth. And Hayden Caldwell is fifth. Colin McGovern sixth. And Justin Heath seventh. They are the cars on the lead lap as the field is pacing through 3 and 4. About to take the green flag. The first car lap down is the 31 down that bottom lane. Jordan Bell right behind the 16 of Eric Willis and the 1 of Tommy Turbo. Green flag. And Bouchard gets clear. Oh, Luke Gray popped the wall again. And look at Jordan Bell on the inside. This could really hurt Derek Bouchard. He's going to hit the wall hard. And here comes Nathan Hood in the 10. He's the one second. Tony Green's behind in third. They're going to hit off the corner. And around they go, the leaders. Tony Green. Oh, my goodness. Oh, and McGovern hit the 21 hard. And right now in front is Derek Bouchard. Hank Caldwell's now up to second in the 47. Justin Heath is third. Let's see what happened. It looked like almost a huge wreck erupted there, but it looks like they kept it a small one. We saw right here Derek Bouchard and Nathan Hood not giving any room. Bouchard hits the wall and has to come off it, but Nathan Hood was just crowding him. Bouchard kept going straight. You see Tony Green had to slam on the brakes, and that made the 21 of Jacob West slam on the brakes. Colin McGovern slammed into the back of the 21 and just spun it. And Derek Bouchard, meanwhile, gets away with the lead. And we will have a restart with under 10 to go. Going back here in lap 69, no cars have retired from that last spin. And again, only 21 cars left in the race and only 9 on the lead lap, but it has grown. Derek Bouchard is your race leader. Hayden Caldwell is second. Justin Heath third. Nathan Hood fourth. And fifth is Tony Green. In sixth is Luke Rainey. Seventh is Colin McGovern. Eighth is Jordan Bell. Ninth is the 16 of Eric Willis. Those are the only cars on the left. Single file restarts. The green flag is back out. Maybe one final time. We can keep it clean for a few laps. Bouchard with the 10 damage to the nose. That's going to hurt him probably. Here comes Hayden Caldwell in the 47. The front four have gotten away from the field. They're going to be the four that can win this race. Six to go. If the caution comes out this time, we will have one final restart. If not, the race is going to end. They're wrecking on the back. I don't see yellow yet. It looked like there was smoke on the back stretch. The front two have gone away. Five to go. This race will end. If a caution comes out, the race is over. Whoa! Caldwell down to the inside wall with Derek Bouchard. Comes back up, and that might just give Bouchard the victory as he has gotten away. As long as he doesn't pit or have something horrible happen to him, he's going to win the race. Bouchard in the wall. Heath is through to second. Three to go right here. We'll end under green. 3 to go at Bristol. And Derek Bouchard's out front. He's trying to run down. Hayden Caldwell's coming down pit road. Maybe because of the damage. Oh, Bouchard in trouble! Here comes Justin Heath. It's going to be a race to the finish now. 2 to go. Bouchard overdriving the corner and the caution is out. That's going to end it. Maybe Jay Jefferson was the one around on the backstretch. There was smoke, but they were going to be coming to the white flag next time. And Justin Heath was going to give Bouchard a run for his money, but the white flag is going to come out this time. Final lap under caution, and it would have been a battle between Justin Heath and Derek Bouchard, and who knows what could have happened. Maybe Heath would have gone around, maybe Bouchard would have held him off, maybe those two would have wrecked and given 3rd, 4th, and 5th a chance. But either way, Bouchard gets it done. Will win at Bristol. He was out front for most of the race. It looks like as he comes through 3 and 4, he's going to win the race. Here they come. A race where only 20 people finished. Derek Bouchard will win the FoodSafe 500. 9 cars finished on the lead lap. We'll have to see what happened to bring out the final caution. We're thinking maybe Jay Jefferson went around on the backstretch. The caution was for Colin McGovern coming off of turn number 2. He hits the wall and it just spins around on him. Jim Gambit got into him. McGovern able to drive away. Everyone able to get through. And that allowed Derek Bouchard to win the race. Justin Heath was coming, but Bouchard able to get it done. Let's check out the finishing results. Here are the finishing results from the FoodSafe 500. Bristol, 10 caution flags for 47 laps, 14 lead changes among 9 drivers, and Derek Bouchard led 28 laps the most. Justin Heath ended up 2nd. He was going to give Bouchard a run for his money. He led 11 laps. Nathan Hood led 10 and ended up 3rd. And Tony Green got 4th. In 5th was Luke Rainey looking for the sweep at Bristol. Couldn't get it done. In 6th was Eric Wills. 7th was Jordan Bell. They're the only ones that are at 6th. Only 6 cars finished on the lead lap. In 8th was Colin McGovern. 9th was Hayden Caldwell. And running at top 10 was the 11 of John Gambit. So there's your top 20. You see down here, Larry Bouchard Sr. led 3 laps, ended up 12th. There you see the 18 of Jim Gambit led 7, ended up 15th. Scroll down, 21st to 40th. You see the 55, Michael Gregory led 8 laps, ended up 22nd. The 98 Ian Shepherd led a lap, ended up 26th. Ken Bell led 5, ended up 28th. Your pole sitter, Gracie Sevilla, led 2, finished 35th. All right, now let's go to the point standings. Here are the point standings after 5 races. Justin Heath is on top. Derek Bouchard, with that win, climbs up to 2nd in the points. In 3rd is Chris Dodd. 4th is Dan Bandon. And 5th is the 88 of Gary May. In 6th is Nathan Hood. 7th is Hayden Caldwell. In 8th is Jeff Bright. 9th is the 99 of John West. And ranking at your top 10 is the 14 of Jay Jefferson. So there's your top 20 in the points. As you see, no one has completed every lap. The closest is Justin Heath. He has completed 235 of the laps. And now no one has led in every race. Gary May had that streak going. Snapped here. All right, so the next race will be the Tums 500 at Martinsville. See you guys then.